beautiful Micronesians. Today is January 29, 2019, Tuesday, and I'm your host, Alana Claire Stedris, and you're tuned into the Micronesian News Broadcast. Let's get into it. Now, the first story, if you're from Kushai, you would probably know Matthew Simpson. Heck, you don't even have to be there to know who he is. Who is this guy we're talking about anyway? Seriously, he is the founder of Green Banana Paper. It is one of the few private sector companies of Kushai. Mr. Simpson held a talk at Guam Community College, and in it he spoke of his experience and why he started up the venture. So let's go back a few years back, 2016 to be exact. Simpson was a teacher on Kushai and was looking to make a bigger impact. As a teacher, I would imagine it's paramount to inspire the students. He also wanted to find a solution to the problem of many young Kushaians leaving home just to work minimum wages abroad. Ouch. According to him, many wanted to stay but couldn't find a job. Using probably Kushai's most abundant resource, you know, besides people and fish, he started the banana paper wallet idea. Using young, determined islanders and smart social media marketing, not to mention Amazon, to promote his brand, expand products, and carry on his mission with helping the young of Kushai. Surprisingly enough, Green Banana Paper is one of the only Micronesian-based companies on Amazon. Gotta drive them traffic. Well, we want to say congratulations to Mr. Simpson for your innovative ideas. What do you think? Let us know in the comments. Angkor State in Palau has found a way to deal with its macaque situation. If you did not know, the monkeys are not native to Palau and are an invasive species. Monkeys outnumber humans and hinder the locals' livelihoods. Some initiatives were put to action to curb the invasive species. Just build a wall. No, but seriously, monkeys will be getting their own nature reserve park, and it will be a sanctuary and a tourist attraction. Two birds with one stone. Plus, it keeps the monkeys away from the community. That will help ease the tensions. A $10,000 check was given just for this reason. The monkeys came here nearly a century ago and is the only place in the region where it has the monkeys. What do you think? Let us know in the comments. Now here are the announcements. Hey guys, here are the announcements. On February 2nd will be the Youth Empowerment Concert at Colonial China Friendship Gym from 5:30 p.m. on, free admission. And February 5 and 6 will be the Japan Film Festival at Bombay Cinema. Four Catholic priests who have served on Bombay and Chuuk have credible evidence mounted against them for sexual abuse. It must be noted that only one Reverend John Doolin, who worked at Xavier High School and Chuuk Parish, admitted to abuses. Each of these clergymen were accused of abuse decades after the incidents took place. The names are Reverend Thomas Denny, who lived and worked at Xavier High School. He was permanently removed from the ministry in 2002 for abuses that happened in the 60s and 70s. Reverend John Doolin worked and lived at Xavier High School from 1957 to 1960 and at Chuuk Parish from 1965 to 1973. Permanently removed from the ministry in 2006, died 2008. Admitted to abuses in the 60s and 70s. Reverend John Garvey worked at Xavier High School from 1968 to 1971, Bombay 1974 to 1978. Abuses happened in 1977 and 1978, but he died in 2011. Reverend John T. Ryan worked at Xavier High School from 1972 to 1973, left the Jesuit order in 2002, and abuses occurred in the 1980s and 1990s. Wow! All cases had credible standing against these celibate men of holiness. This is definitely not the year of the Catholic Church. from the Pennsylvania pedophile ring and the extensive cover-ups. Jeez. If you or anyone you know is a victim of abuse or any abuse by priests, Concerned Catholics of Guam want to help you. Now here's Norman with the weather.
Hey guys, this is Norman and this is the weather for tomorrow. 27 degrees Celsius high during the day and 23 degrees Celsius low during the night. Partly cloudy and 10% chance of precipitation and 75% of humidity. Sunrise will be at 6:45 a.m. and sunset will be at 6:34 p.m. East winds 10 to 15 knots and seas will be at 7 to 8 feet high.
Thanks for tuning into the Micronesian News Broadcast. Tune in at the Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday for more updates. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Until next time.